Singer, actress, and entertainer, Lebo Mathosa was one of the most important stars born and bred in South Africa. This episode celebrates the incredible, iconic legacy she left us, along with her unforeseen tragic departure that shook the entire country. The musical journey of Lebo Mathosa started in 1984 at the tender age of 7 when she joined her local church choir in Daveyton. Her family later moved to Johannesburg, where she matriculated at St. Mary's High School, whilst discovering a newfound love of bubblegum music fronted by the likes of Brenda Fassie and Yvonne Chaka Chaka. As a high school scholar, Lebo would often take trips to Hillbrow to visit her mentor Brenda Fassie, who had also dubbed her as the next Brenda Fassie. It was also during this time that she caught the attention of DJ Christos at a Hillbrow nightclub where she performed a song by Shantae Moore. DJ Christos brought her along to meet DJ Oskido, who then introduced Lebo to Tembi Siete at his studio.
So you go to Ozzy's studio, meet yes. Lebo, and then? Because I'm sure you saw Lebo's rough around the edges. Like, I look at Skumba, I'm like, hello, I'm Polish.
Yeah, he actually sat me down and then he said, Tembi, you have to meet this lady because you guys have, you know, something similar going on. The yeah. energy and the passion and just that, you know, the love for music. And I was like, you know what? I'll sacrifice, to cut the long story short, I'll make sure that I am here during the week because obviously I was at school. So obviously we have Gulisanyana and all of that just to go and meet this lady, you know? And when I eventually met Ulebo, that was the beginning of my life, yeah. the beginning of the biggest thing. I couldn't believe, you know, there are people like that, you know, such power and talent and passion really existed. I didn't know. Mm-hmm. It's the kind of thing that you'd see on stage, I mean, on TV or hear about it on radio or something. It was just rare.
Yeah.
Talking to IOL, Siete stated, Lebo was extremely talented but lacked self-confidence. The cause of that was that she did not grow up with her parents. She did not have anyone to encourage and support her when her career was starting. I was living with my mom and had all the support I needed, but she did not have any of that. I became her support system, and together we encouraged and pushed each other to the limits to succeed in our careers. The duo, along with Theo Nhlengethwa and Junior Sokela, enhanced their skills as underground artists and eventually started booking performances under the name Boom Shaka in clubs around Hillbrow and Yeovil. Mathosa shot to fame in 1994 as the lead singer and dancer of the pioneering Kwaito group. Preparing the fans for her debut album, Lebo released Intro, an EP that solidified her presence in the music scene. The project consisted of street hits such as Tsoriyo and Kumbule Kaya, which were heavily influenced by Brenda Fassie's sound at the time. This was only the beginning to the star that is Lebo Mathosa. In 2000, she ventured into a solo career and her debut album Dream went gold within a month of its launch, spawning the hot single Ndoza Bantu. The album won 3 South African Music Awards, namely Best Dance Album, Best Dance Single, and Best Female Vocalist the following year. It was also during this time where she was headhunted by American R&B sensation Keith Sweat for a collaboration, as the Twisted hitmaker had plans to release an international remix of his R&B hit I'll Trade a Million Bucks featuring Little Mo. Mathosa sent her vocals in, but unfortunately, the song was never released. Mathosa's publicist, Marang Sishwayelo, recalled how Mathosa released her debut album completely self-financed. By so doing, Mathosa was able to secure full publishing rights and ownership of her work. This was not unheard of when it came to Mathosa's activism, as she fought for the same rights for Boom Shaka's music. Mathosa was in dispute with her label after the release of the album Dream for 4 years, as they wouldn't let her leave. This resulted in Mathosa not being able to move forward and record music for 3 years. During this time, Lebo found it difficult to sustain herself and live, opening her eyes to who her real friends were. Her absence caused rumors to stir, such as her being dead. Mathosa erased the rumors as she bagged reoccurring acting roles on the hit television series Generations and Mobango. It was in 2003 where she had her big break in her short-lived acting career, when she was casted in the film Soldiers of the Rock, playing the role of Tandi, a doctor. The movie went on to be screened at the Cannes Film Festival. Lebo was performing all over the world, from the Kora Awards, also referred to as the Grammys of Africa, as an opening act for Missy Elliott, to the North Sea Jazz Festival, and in Malaysia, where she performed for the Malaysian Queen. She also showcased her talents at Trafalgar Square in London and toured the US with the show The Vagina Monologues. One of her most significant performances being at Nelson Mandela's 85th birthday party, where the Clintons and Oprah Winfrey were in attendance. Lebo released her sophomore album, Drama Queen, in 2004, featuring hit singles Audete and I Love Music, which were on heavy rotation on radio and local music channels. This era launched her to new commercial and creative heights, abandoning the kwaito sensibilities of her previous music in favor of soul and funk. With her sophomore album, Speaking to Mail and Guardian, Iko Mesh, who was her makeup artist, stated in that period she assessed what she wanted to do, and her sophomore album was a sort of a Lebo relaunch. He believed 2004 was the year she took control of not only her music, but her brand and business interests. It was the beginning of what Lebo Mathosa is about, vocally in control of her persona and everything. She knew exactly who she wanted to work with and what music she wanted to make. She'd grown up.
And I didn't know much about the industry when I, you know, came in the scene, because I was 14 years old and I was always driven around, you know, like a puppet. And just because you enjoyed and you loved what you were doing, you'd go on that stage and break a leg. So I had to back out a little bit, learn about the industry, look at my mistakes that I did before and now, and choose what is it that I want to do.
Following the success of her sophomore album, Lebo released her third and final studio album, Lioness, with the summer hit single Brand New Day. The demand for Lebo Mathosa had extended beyond the continent of Africa. She was invited to perform at the launch of MTV Base Africa in 2005. So impressive was she that MTV Base selected Lebo to perform all over the continent. She traveled with MTV Base to the 2005 MTV Europe Awards, where Madonna made her comeback performance in front of grand stars like Shakira and the Black Eyed Peas, to name a few. Mathosa graced the red carpet hand in hand with the actual creator of MTV, Bill Rudy, who introduced her to many artists at the event. In 2006, Lebo Mathosa was nominated for Best African Act Award at the Music of Black Origin, also known as the MOVO Awards in the UK, which saw her walk the red carpet with other rising stars such as the young Rihanna, Corinne Bailey-Ray, and Jamelia.
Hello everyone.
How you doing?
It's our pleasure to be presenting the MOVO for Best African Act.
And the nominations for the Best African Act are...
Best African Act. Tony Tatula. I'm in love with two women, I don't know which one to take.
Lebo Mathosa.
Two months before her sudden departure, Lebo suffered a huge loss when her father sadly passed away. In her grief, Tembi Siete told IOL that after visiting Lebo 2 weeks prior to her death, she had allegedly talked about wanting to change her life, to quote-unquote, get married, have children, and lead a stable life.
When are you getting married? We're getting old.
Because I have a boyfriend. I have a man now. This is her telling me. But already bashimani, you don't like boys. No, I find myself a man. You know why? Because I want to have a baby. When are you going to have a baby? I was like, but I just started jigger now. I can't be like dancing with a tummy.
You know?
But that was her saying, I'm a different person, sending messages to me. It's like, this is like the next chapter of my life. It's the next chapter. It's all knowing.
In the early hours of October 22nd, 2006, Lebo Mathosa was last seen happily conversing and partying with friends at YFM station manager Bondo Ntuli's birthday party in Parktown. She was in happy spirits and excited to be done recording her fourth album. At about 11:20 p.m., Lebo left with a friend and two others in Lebo's sponsored 4x4 Toyota Prado Land Cruiser. After dropping off the two other passengers at their residence, the vehicle crashed into a tree on the N3 highway near Germiston. The vehicle rolled numerous times and Lebo was flung from the car and died minutes later. According to eyewitness, locals had been woken by a sound like the roof of a house being ripped off. Lebo had been lying meters away from the damaged Land Cruiser. The driver allegedly climbed out of the vehicle, seemingly dazed by the impact. He ran up the highway, then back to the car. He knelt next to Lebo and began speaking to her. She groaned a couple of times and he proceeded to shout for help. Paramedics arrived on the scene and upon realizing they could not save her, the driver started weeping. The paramedics gave up after battling to revive her for 15 minutes and declared Mathosa dead at 1:05 a.m. Lebo had no visible marks on her body, but suffered major injuries on her upper torso and neck. Her death was a shock to many, as celebrities and fans expressed their devastation. Many artists performed tributes for her months to come and years after her passing. The most unforgettable tribute was a song legendary Kwaito group Trompies recorded for her titled Madibu Sing, a tribute to Lebo. Lebo was a true queen, a music legend and style icon. She had achieved so much with the little time she had with us on earth. Her ghetto fabulous take on R&B, her unapologetic style and taking control of her sensuality. The certified international superstar that many artists aspire to be. Most influential to the amapiano vocalists we see today. Lebo ushered in today's favorites such as Yokamon Pillars, Bobby Cooper, Babes Wodumo, Chomi, and many others. A breath of fresh air, daring fashions, a stage presence unmatched, and the most captivating voice we are certain never to be rivaled by others after her. She may be gone, but her impact will live on forever. Rest in heavenly peace, Lioness.